Hey, friends and neighbors, it's Pastor David from Walden Community Church. Thanksgiving is right around the corner. It is, isn't it? And I don't know what your Thanksgiving plans are. My plans are we're going back to California to see the family. If you didn't know that already, I'm actually originally from California. My wife and I are from California. And those of you, I guess, that didn't know that, now you're thinking to yourself, okay, that makes a lot of sense. That explains a lot. No, it really doesn't. I haven't been to home though. I haven't been home for Thanksgiving in a really long time. So I'm kind of looking forward to this. I'm excited about this. I really am. I don't know how you feel about seeing the family at Thanksgiving time or holiday time, or if you just look at your watch and say, okay, I have to go see the family. Because there's always going to be people there that we've seen recently, but then a lot of people we haven't seen in a while, right? Aunts, uncles, cousins, nephews, nieces, there'll be grandparents and parents, and maybe some boyfriends and girlfriends that we've never met before, and brand new brides, brand new babies. You could be excited about a lot of it, and you could be anxious about some of it. I pulled some funny quotes off the internet about family. Ralph Buss said, "Children really brighten up a house because they never turn the lights off." Bob Hope said, "I grew up with six brothers. That's how I learned to dance, waiting for the bathroom." Buddy Hackett said, "As a child, my family's menu consisted of two choices, take it or leave it." And Sam Levinson said, "The reason why grandparents and grandchildren get along so well is because they have a common enemy." And George Burns said, "Happiness is having a large, loving, caring, close-knit family in another city." But that's not always the case, right? That's not always the case. Many of us love our families, love everybody in it. We're excited to see everybody. Others of us, we kind of wonder, is my family some sort of cosmic joke? Like, God, why did you place me with these strange people? But hey, there's no such thing as a perfect family, right? Do you have a perfect family? Probably not. I don't have a perfect family. None of us do. I know there's people out there that act like they have a perfect family. They're that manicured YouTube, Instagram, Facebook family, and you're like, oh my gosh, they look so perfect. Nobody's perfect, right? And the good news is there's no perfect families even in the Bible. The Bible doesn't have any examples of perfect families. You think about Cain and Abel, were sibling rivals. Noah, he got drunk and he passed out in front of his kids. Jacob showed favoritism to one of his children and that ended up wrecking his entire family. David committed adultery and had huge marital problems. We don't see perfect families even in Scripture. So I guess that's the good news. But with that, the bad news is, as society evolves, as we become more adept at the internet and social media, many more people than ever before are experiencing feelings of loneliness. People feel like they don't know their own family and their own friends that well. Single people, more than ever, are raising families than ever before. And it's becoming more and more easy to pull away from society, to pull away from friends, to even pull away from God, and to live life alone, and to experience brokenness. Many of us don't just have weird people in our family. Some of us have brokenness and things that haunt us, and we don't know how to feel this Thanksgiving. Do we feel thankful for our families? That's what we want to talk about this Sunday at Walden Church. We've got two services for you. We have our 9:30 service with our traditional hymns and choir, and we have our 11 o'clock service with our more contemporary worship team. We also have a full children's program at 11 from birth all the way through high school. A couple other calendar items coming up in December. Of course, we have our annual Christmas choir concert. It's free for the entire community. Please come and bring your neighbors. It's going to be a wonderful time together listening to our choir. That's December 14th and 15th. Both concerts are identical and they are at 6 o'clock. Then we'll have our Christmas Eve service on December 24th. And again, both services are the same. You're not going to miss anything. It is a candlelight service, and I know a lot of people like that. That's going to be at 5 o'clock and 7 o'clock. So choose the service that works best for you and yours. We want to be your local church. Have a great Thanksgiving and a wonderful Christmas.